Sports. So the Eagles with the lead, and they're going to get this football first as the third quarter gets underway. And he will not bring it out. It's a touchback. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And they've got the lead, CD. What do you expect from them in the second half?
Well, I liked what they were able to do on the ground in the first half because they had a lot of success running the ball, and I certainly think we'll see more of that. But I'd keep an eye on that defense, and I think their coaches up in the box will do the exact same thing. If they start to see one or two guys start to creep towards the line of scrimmage, that'll be licensed to take some shots downfield.
The run got four. Now they deal with a second and six. They'll go again with Sanders. 101 yards rushing for him now, and he's carried the ball just five times.
Now that's the way to do it. Hand it to someone with vision and good footwork, and add it a little bit of power, and you find a way to pick up first downs.
They'll run on first down. Sanders. And that'll hurt the average a bit as this time they're able to get him behind the line. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11. They just do get the playoff as he'll look to throw. Going deep here for Watkins. And that's caught inside the 30. Touchdown! Chris Watkins. Two catches, two touchdowns here so far. And the Eagles able to push further out in front.
In order to lead in a game, you're going to get plenty of contributors. But that's his second touchdown catch of this game. He's one of the key guys in this one.
And you better believe he'll be looking for the hat trick here as this one continues to go. Elliott now to add the extra point. After the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. And they're going to mark that where it went out of bounds. So really good starting field position up past the 40-yard line. So good starting field position for him here as they come up first and 10 at their own 42. Darnold. Dancing to his left. And that going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down.
Well, defensively, they haven't let him just sit in the pocket and get comfortable. And that's opposite a lot of game plans in today's NFL. Ordinarily, you're trying to keep the quarterback hemmed in. In this case, they've brought the heat. And if he flushes out, they're fine with that. And they force another incompletion.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. A play fake, and it's Darnold. being chased out left. And able to catch it on the left sideline, but they're going to rule him out of bounds. So it'll be incomplete, certainly one they'd like to have back as it brings up fourth down. Still just the third quarter, but they've got to make something happen. I think they know that. They're going for it on fourth. They snap it. They're going for it. Here's Darnold. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. Boy, a curious decision to go for it. Doesn't pan out, and the Eagles are going to take over in great field position. Play clock down to zero, and this is not the way to start a drive. So a little bit of a stiffer challenge now, first and 15 following the delay of game. On the counter now, it's Sanders. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down. They'll set up a throw. And it's a leaping effort, but it's knocked away and incomplete. Not his best throw there, but where we sit right now in the third quarter, he's had a pretty good game throwing the football.
He certainly has, and it's not exactly at the point where we're doing four-minute offense yet, but they've got to think about, I'm not going to say milking the clock, but understanding clock management here on out.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Now Sanders finds a seam inside the 40. And he's going to be taken down at the 39, clearly short of the first by a few yards. Now the defense going to use the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with two remaining. We'll be back after this. Feeling like they're not quite in field goal range yet, they're going to go for it on fourth. Going for it with Sanders. 30, almost to the 25.
That was fourth and what we would call long in that situation, wasn't it? That wasn't fourth and inches, was it?
No, I mean, you get in those situations, fourth and three, fourth and four, that's a lot to, what would you say, a lot of pizza left in that box.
It certainly is. Not everyone dove in on that one. In today's NFL, this is a passing down. All right, this is not a running down. That takes a lot of guts to call that play, and even better execution.
And nowhere to fit that football in. It's knocked away and incomplete.
Yes, sir. How about an attaboy there on first down? Got his hand in and knocked it away.
Second and 10 now. Third quarter action from Philadelphia, PA. Here comes the blitz as they look to throw. letting one go deep for the end zone. And Goddard's got it. Touchdown, Eagles. Dallas Goedert, 27 yards. And the Eagles add on to their lead.
You have fun with this one, partner.
I am. I mean, he's been fun to watch under center.
We always talk about, you know, getting to the next level, right? When we see people get into the zone, this guy's in the master class right now. What a performance he's putting on, just carving them up.
Four touchdown passes, carving them up is right. Seems like everything he throws is going to be a completion and going in the end zone. Elliott good on the extra point, and the lead opens up now to 22 points. Taken at the goal line. And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And last time out, went for it on fourth down, turned it over, gave him great field position, turned into 6 points, so they've got to recover here, Charles.
It's amazing what one decision can do in the chain of events, right? The decision to go for it on fourth down.
Caused all of that.
It caused every bit of it, but it showed confidence. Hey, I've got confidence in you guys. Go pick it up for them. Didn't happen. Also showed confidence in the defense. They didn't pick up their end of the bargain, so now they've got to come back out and start over and rebuild that confidence.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. To throw is Darnold. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down. Three quarters in the books. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. First down, it's Darnold. Open man left side, it's the tight end Trimble. And he's able to break out of one tackle, but then quickly brought down. Looking to throw again on second down. Darnold. That is caught by Anderson. And he has another first down as he'll get the ball down to the Eagles 28. Darnold now to throw. That caught by Trimble. A gain of 6 there on first. Second and 4. Now it's Darnold. That is caught. It's Anderson. Touchdown, Panthers. Robbie Anderson. There to make the grab. And the Panthers have got it back to a 2-score game here in the fourth. So here's Darnold now as he'll lead his guys up to go for two. They're going to throw for the two with Darnold. To the end zone, but knocked away and incomplete.
I don't know about you, but I can't wait for a few years of 2-point tries and see what the data tells us, because a lot of teams want to throw the ball in this situation, this time unsuccessfully. I just wonder if maybe running the ball might be the way to go.
With it moved up from the 3 to the 2, you would think maybe a few more attempts at running.
I think stats over time may bear out that running the ball will at least be the equal of throwing it in that situation.
First down, Hurts. Quick slant here to Smith. And they're able to get this one past the 30 to the 25-yard line.
Partner, I like that they're staying aggressive on offense because, to me, this drive is what is known as a put-away drive. You score here, that might put this one to bed. I like the fact that they're playing with confidence and not playing with fear.
On first and 10, it's Hurts. And that one drops down incomplete. Good coverage there. Forced the ball free, and it's second down. An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Hurts sets up to throw it. Buying time to his left. And he's taken down, trying to do a little too much, getting outside of the pocket, and it results in a sack. Brian Burns able to take him down. It's a loss of three. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And intercepted, maybe the turning point they need. Jeremy Chinn picks it off. And now off to the races, down the right side. And he will bring this one back. It's a pick six for a Panther touchdown.
Well, don't change that channel just yet. This one may have gotten a bit more interesting.
Put down the remote, put down the clicker. This one looked like it was over. It looked like they were ready to seal the deal. But in doing so, by pitching it around a little bit, it cost them. We could have a great finish.
So the touchdown was big. This almost equally big as he'll try to get it to a one-score game with a two-point conversion. He'll buy some time right.
And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off by Avante Maddox, and the Panthers are right back in this football game.
Two scores down, two timeouts at their disposal. This is a critical onside kick. And the Eagles hand needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of an anecdotal type of a number, kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical.
First play of the drive goes the wrong way. Here's second and 12. On this day, the ground has been his, but at least on that individual play, we just saw the defense finally with a win.
Yeah, they finally got one, and that's a win for them, but all game long, he's seen the holes, and they've been huge for him. Kind of like a baseball hitter in the zone. The ball seems bigger, and he's just whacking it. These guys, they've got it going today.
So it's Eagle football here as we get you reset. Now this is a big third down, and you'd have to think we'd see a timeout right away if they can't stop them here. They run the counter. It's Sanders. 3 yards won't be enough here as that'll bring up fourth down. And quickly we're going to get another stop here with 1:54 left as they call the timeout defensively. So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. This from 54 yards away. And that is no good. I hit it well from distance, but he couldn't work it back in. And this score will stay right where it is.
Now, Charles, all things considered, I guess that's not a critical miss at this stage, is it?
No, but still everything helps when you're trying to finish off a ball game. And you're right, not critical in terms of the scoreboard and the team, but the guy with the golden foot, he knows he's only as good as his last kick.
And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. He'll get 8 on the scramble there. It'll be 2nd and a couple. Darnold to throw. Steps away to his left. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. Well, there you go. Save your best scramble of the day for a big-time situation in the 4th quarter, picking up the 1st.
You don't want to use it up early, right? You want to make sure you save it for that exact moment, that key time. And that's what he did, although you and I both know it wasn't planned that way. But what a nice job using his eyes, scanning the field, and realizing when it was time to exit the pocket and go.
Now Darnold. Flushed out right. Nothing open downfield, so he'll throw it away.
Whew, that's certainly not the worst thing. It stops the clock and lets your offense catch its breath and lets us exhale a little bit. Now I expect them to call a couple plays in the huddle, so they're ready if a tackle happens inbounds.
Darnold. And he's got the hook up to Moore. And he gets it down a yard or two shy of the 30 before he's out of bounds. 5 yards. Now it's 3rd and 5.
What terrifies defenses when they see slant routes thrown is that the receiver is on the move, and oftentimes he catches it and gets upfield. Does a really nice job rallying to him and stopping him for a minimal gain.
Here's Darnold. Forced out to his left. And he's left with no option here but to throw it away.
And let's face it, this defense has had its share of struggles all game long, and they know that they can put it all behind them if they defend well here in the 2-minute drill. Excellent coverage right there to force the incompletion.
Gonzalez's kick is good. And this is back down to a 7-point game. So the field goal means we're back to a 1-score game, but with no timeouts left, I think this has to be an onside kick.
I like your analysis there, partner. I think you're right. You need the ball back. That's probably your only avenue.
And the Eagles dodge a bullet. They cover it up. They had to go for it with no timeouts remaining, though, now. This one's as good as over.
They gave it an effort. They tried their best, did everything they could to try and get the ball on the onside kick. You're exactly right. They had to try it. It was their only option. And now this game is done. Just take it, kneel, and call it a day.
On 1st down, it's Sanders. And he'll take it inside the 40 to the 39-yard line. Give him 3 on 1st down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7. I guess the simple question, why not just take a knee there?
I don't understand either why you would take any sort of a chance. We've seen it happen in the game of football. It doesn't matter whether you've watched high school, college, or the NFL. Some people get a little greedy, try to get that extra running play in, and it can backfire on them.
Hurts down to 1 knee, and that should just about do it. Well, taking that knee, maybe just a sigh of relief. They withstood a big 4th quarter comeback, able to hold on, though.
Certainly looked like they had things going their way, didn't it? In the 4th quarter, they had to just hold on. As you said, furious assault on them, but they were able to get it done, take a knee, and head to the locker room with a win.